America Show. I am Contessa with a great show for you today. As you know, Pinup America is everything pinup, burlesque, rockabilly, custom culture, tattoos, and newly featuring, we have roller derby girls. And in the newest issue of the Pinup America magazine with a gorgeous Bernie Dexter on the cover, in this issue, we are featuring the Rocky Mountain roller derby girls from Denver, Colorado. So they're going to be the first segment up today. And then following that, I'm going to be teaching you guys how to pose like a pinup. So for all you newbies out there wanting to get a little more insight on how to properly pose, I'm going to be teaching you guys how to pose on a couch. And then last but not least, Pinup America and a lot of our lovely pinup girls, we all went down to Plant City for the Strawberry Classic Plant City car show out there. So you guys are going to see not only our lovely pinups, but some amazing, gorgeous cars as well. So stick around.
DJ, come to my rescue. Heads down to the sound of a heartbeat. I knew the moment I met you, you were naughty. DJ, come to my rescue. Heads pedal to the metal in your backseat.
Features in the magazine. It is the Rocky Mountain Roller Girls from Denver, Colorado. They're an amazing roller derby team. Let me tell you a little bit about them. They actually have five teams under their big belt, which includes the Kill Scouts, Boom Daisies, Red Robin Hoods, Sugar Kill Gang, the United States Pummeling Service, and two travel teams, which consist of 5280 Fight Club and the Contenders, as well as the juniors team, Rocky Mountain Roller Punks, which range from 4 to 17 years of age. They are one big, big family. The Rocky Mountain Roller Girls was started in 2004 with great determination and a lot of fun, winning several bouts, including the 2010 WFTDA Western Regionals Championship. Great job, girls. So let's see them in action.
Take this pink ribbon off my eyes. I'm exposed, and it's no big surprise. Don't you think I know exactly where I stand? This world is forcing me to hold your hand. 'Cause I'm just a girl, but they don't know me. Well, don't let me out of your sight. Oh, I'm just a girl, already up for G. So don't let me out.
tons of variations and tons of things and poses that you guys can do. If you were just going to sit on the couch, I wouldn't keep my legs together like this because it's not very pinup. What I would do is I would split my legs, and then I would put one hand over my knee and really arch. Make sure I get my hair out of the way. It's because you need to show off your assets. So I would, you know, make sure that I'm posing. I would lean back. You know, I could even put my legs out and sit up. The classic poses that everyone loves to do, and it really, no matter what size you are, it looks beautiful and sexy, and a lot of people, when I'm doing workshops, it's their favorite move. If you don't have a strong core, this move could be a little more difficult for you to hold. The one key thing to do is, when you're doing like a kick up, if you're working with a photographer and you can't keep your legs, you can't, you know, hold one leg here and hold there, the best thing for you to do is get communication with your photographer and do a count. One, two, three, pose. One, two, three, pose. That way, you're not sitting there the whole time while he's doing the lights, while he's fixing this, while he's taking another picture, while, you know, there's all these things going on. You're not holding your pose the entire time, which can be very strenuous on you. So, this is a kick up. Whether you're lying on the floor or lying on the couch, no matter where you are, you can still do this. Now you're gonna keep one leg straight and one leg bent. Now, this looks cute, but it's not as cute as this. So again, my technique when I'm doing poses, I always make sure that the one that I'm holding angled is the one towards the photographer. Now, another thing to be conscious of is your feet. If you can see this foot, I turned it in, don't do that. Always be conscious of where your feet are positioned. Don't turn your feet in, don't turn them out. Make sure that they are straight for the photo, for the viewer, for the photographer, okay? So again, if you can't hold it up there that long, you can go one, two, three, up, okay? Another thing, when you're laying on a couch, if I was just going to do a pose, I'm not going to want to keep my back straight on the couch. What I'm going to want to do is I'm going to take my shoulder towards the photographer, angle that just over the edge of the couch. What that does is that automatically opens me up towards the photographer. And then I can bend my foot, put the other one straight out. Again, I'm not going to keep my foot this way. I'm always going to point my toes. And when you point, it also, you know, brings definition to your legs and your muscles. So I'm going to take my shoulder, put it a little bit over the couch. It opens me up, and then I can lay here, take some photos, okay? Another thing to do on couches, use the sides of the couch. You can put your legs together, okay? Bend over, so then you see all your angles. Then you can take your feet, split them, and then pose. Okay? Lots of little things to do. If you got really long legs, and there's also ways to make yourself look even longer. I'm 5'3". That's another thing. The reason why I always point, it keeps the line going. So it makes your legs look longer than they actually are. Because if you put a stop to it, your legs are going to stop right there instead of keeping the line going. When you're doing, if you want to get longer legs, just make sure that you hold them out, okay? And also, it's gonna be a responsibility of the photographer too, because if he shot this way from the bottom of my feet, it's gonna make me look like my legs go on for miles and miles, but they really don't. So hopefully, you guys got some fun techniques to do for doing some pinup photography on a couch.
lot of fun, and I felt really comfortable in each of the settings, and the photos turned out really great.
Contessa here at the Plant City Strawberry Classic Car Show. How are you guys doing tonight?
Good.
Yay, I'm so glad that you came out. You have a gorgeous, gorgeous car. What's your name?
Oscar.
Oscar, where are you from, Oscar?
Right here from Plant City.
Woo, local. Tell us about your gorgeous car.
Oh, yeah. Well, we just put that car together in about 2 years from now, 2 years ago. My friends, we all worked on it, and we enjoy riding.
Oh, nice!
We just like cars.
Oh, that's great. So you guys built it together?
Yeah. All three of us here.
All three of you guys?
Mm-hmm.
Very nice. What was the hardest thing to put together? Was it the engine? Was it the framework?
I don't know. I think the painting is the hardest part.
The painting? Oh.
The painting was the hardest part.
Is it the original color?
No.
No?
No, it's Corvette red.
Nice. Very, very nice. Well, thank you so much.
Thank you.
A beautiful day, I said, yeah.
It was a beautiful day.
It's all going my way.
Well, so beautiful.
And then she pulled beside me, gave a wink and made my day. Well, I could hear her radio playing. It was just a beautiful day, I said, yeah.
It was a beautiful day.
It's all going my way.
Was so beautiful.
Oh yeah, listen what I say.
It's not a day where the bills were late.
Tonight I got me a second day.
Walk around now singing a song.
Hey guys, thanks so much for sticking around. Told you it was a great show. You not only got to see pinups and classic cars and some badass roller derby girls. Thank you so much to Rocky Mountain Roller Derby Girls. And also, I got to show you guys how to do some posing on a couch. So overall, an amazing show today. Thank you guys so much for sticking around, and we will see you next week.